Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Frozen City on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5 that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. We will be able to easily download and install Frozen City and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Frozen City. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all my friends, the first thing to do is to launch our favorite web browser. We selected the one we use by default. Let's go to the current URL I'm highlighting in green color. There you are seeing it on the screen of the PC. There is no need to type the URL, because there's a clickable link in the description of this video and as well in the first main comment. We ended up on this page on our site of Usitility, in which we get an in-depth outline on how to obtain Frozen City on personal computer. We search down a tad and press on the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on that link, we get to the site of BlueStacks. No panic, it is just the Android emulator that we are going to run to play Frozen City on our PC. As you can discover here, we have a number of advantages of preferring using this emulator. So we are on the way to proceed to download the Frozen City by simply clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that you can visualize here in green color. The step is clicking on it. And the download step takes no time at all. Here it is, here is located the download. It is a file to execute. The following step is to run the installer, okay, then we click on the file. If we are on Windows 10 it will have asked us for permission to allow modifications to the computer. We clicked yes. I minimize the web browser to view the installation software better. The installer is very easy to use. It contains two choices, install, and setup path. I will explain what setup path truly does. We only click on it. And then we discover that we get here the path where in fact the emulator is going to be set up. If we plan to vary this directory we have got to click on that browse option, and now we select another directory and install the emulator specifically where we prefer. To keep it simple, just keep it as it is. I simply click on back. So I just click on install. Voila! The install begins and it's going to continue in the download of those megabytes which are represented on that screen. When you download it, it might possibly be slightly more or less MB. The download rate will go at a higher speed or slower, based on your connection and depending on the velocity of the emulator web servers. Right now they are working extremely fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At present, the emulator has actually been launched successfully. As you can discover, down here, we have a progress bar which will move forward to the right so when it attains the finish, the emulator will be started for the first time. The fact is the emulator is already started, here it is for the first time. Before we carry on, as you understand, it has made two software icons right here on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks Multi Instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon is definitely the one we are interested in. When we have to start Frozen City on the desktop or laptop, we twice click this particular app icon and as a result use the emulator. The BlueStacks Multi Instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Shall we perform the next phase, which is actually a requirement, and that's to log on to the Google Play Store. And we'll mouse click on Play Store. As you can see now the Google Play is presented. At this point we must sign in. So now as soon as we're right here, we are required to perform this next step that is compulsory. Therefore we simply click on Sign In. Presently it announces Checking Info. It may once in a while get blocked in checking info, and so it doesn't advance. If that's the case, you should attempt to log in after a couple of hours but it will surely almost certainly be solved. At this time we shall type in our email and password. The email has to be a Gmail email address as well as its corresponding password. For instance you could use the exact same email you are using at this time in your own YouTube account. So that I will submit my details and I'll return when I have accomplished it. Voila, details typed. And here is Google welcoming us and providing us their twos. We are going to consent to them all by simply hitting, I agree. Following that, it allows us to backup to the Google Cloud. You can also let it checked and this will build a backup of your data files on that device to Google Drive. I won't check it, you do what you want. We just click on accept. Google Play Store is started automatically and instantly. To set up the app, we need to get to the emulator desktop for Android by double-clicking on the app icon marked in green. At this point that we are watching the desktop of that Android emulator, we notice that we now have right here the install application button. We simply click on this button. On this page we access to the video game. Let's simply click right here on the install option that I'm just showing now in green. This action will initiate the setup. Straight away it would download on your PC and set up the game app. It might take quite some time, or perhaps it could possibly be extremely fast. It all relies upon on our own internet access. This has just completed setting up. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by simply clicking that option that I'm presenting in green, that allows you to start Frozen City for the first time. We're currently on the emulator desktop, and so we are about to mouse click on that new Frozen City app icon which has been created. This Android game is started for the first time. So there we get it, I can press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I should talk about the volume level of this emulator. It is right here. We have got the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume. This manner we are not going to rely on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of your emulator. And also to appreciate the experience to the max, we will switch on the big screen, for which we have two choices. This one is simply the first one. We mouse click on this particular icon which I am pointing out in green color. Thus the display screen is maximized, getting one border on top, one on the right side and the last one at the bottom. Granted that we wish to run the application using all the screen, we click on this particular game icon. And we might by now be experiencing and enjoying the Android game in 100% screen mode. To quit the 100% screen mode, hit the F11 key. And we might by now play in regular display mode. At this point, I am ready to reveal you the computer keys mapping that is actually rather exciting. This step we definitely will be in a position to utilize the video game more easily. The first task is to press this application icon. It's now time to get the required controls. Let me leave the standard settings, but if you prefer to change this, you can also do this without having problem. Obviously, the emulator is absolutely in our language. In certain cases it occurs that your emulator is launched in the erroneous language, for instance, in Chinese. And thus to set it up in the correct language we browse here to the cogwheel. Then right here inside of various other configurations, we mouse click on the language drop down. We should decide on the language we wish, Italian, Chinese, etc. Once the language is selected, we are going to save, the emulator will reboot, as well as the game app, the next time we run it, will also be in the chosen language. At present, you will find another element that we will need to take into consideration, and it's that we will receive a message from Google Mail telling that a brand new machine has been connected to this Google account. It will likely ask us if we're the people who have associated with that electronic device. Of course, we shouldn't be troubled, since the emulator is acting as an Android electronic device. So you can identify which electronic device is currently being emulated. We return here, to the cogwheel and we then click on it. Be sure to go here to the model selection. And now we notice that the emulator is acting as a Samsung mobile. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all guys, so much for that training. I sincerely hope you enjoyed it, especially that everyone thought it was helpful. If that's the case, give it a great thumb up, subscribe, and any feedback, requests or ideas, leave them in the comment area below. You could even leave a remark on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams every once in a while, you get it listed below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Check out any of these online videos which are usually showing up on the listing of videos to watch and see you in the next online videos. Bye!